This video is about recursion and backtracking. The factorial function is a classic inductive mathematical function. The factorial function is defined as follows. If the input of the function is the natural number 1, then the factorial function returns 1. This is the so-called base case. If the input of the function is a higher natural number x, then the factorial function returns the product of x and the factorial function of x minus 1. This is the induction step. We can directly implement this inductive function as an algorithm. Here is the factorial function in Python code. We define the function f and then test what value the input has. If the input is 1, then we return the base case of the induction 1. Else, we return x times the factorial of x minus 1. You can see that the inductive mathematical definition and the Python program are very close. This Python function is an example of a recursive algorithm. Recursion is one of the most powerful tools in our programming toolbox. An algorithm that splits up a problem into subproblems and invokes itself on the subproblem is called a recursive algorithm. A recursion ends when reaching a simple base case that can be solved directly. Let's see what happens if we call our function f with an input of 5. The function f goes to the else statement and returns 5 times f of 4. Now the function f calls itself again, but with 4 as an input. Again, if we look into the function, we see that this time it returns 4 times f of 3. Then f of 3 is called, then f of 2, and finally f of 1. Now in this last case, the input x is indeed equal to 1, so we immediately return 1 to the calling function f of 2, which then can return 2 times 1, which equals 2, and so all the way back up. We learn that the result of f of 4 is 24, and so f of 5 computes 120. In summary, a recursive function is a function which calls itself. Next, let's look at a more interesting function, which is known as the Knapsack problem. In the Knapsack problem, we are given a set of items. In our example, we will use a set of fruits. Every fruit has a weight. The apple, for instance, weighs 80 grams, and the melon weighs 500 grams. In addition, every fruit has a value. This value signifies how much we like the fruit. For example, the apple has a value of 10. In the Knapsack problem, we want to compute a function with two parameters. The first parameter is a set of items, in our case fruits. Each item has a value and a weight. The second parameter is a capacity. We are trying to find a subset of the items such that the total weight of the items in the subset is at most the capacity. We are looking for the subset which has the maximum sum of values. What is the best subset of fruits if our capacity is 500 grams? This is a good point for you to pause the video and think about the problem by yourself for a minute. We could simply take the melon as it is exactly 500 grams. Its value is 30. This is not bad. But probably you found a better solution by taking some of the smaller fruit. For instance, all these smaller fruits have a total weight of 480 grams, which is within our capacity limit of 500 grams. However, together they are more valuable than the melon, with a total value of 43. If you want to try to improve the value of 43, just pause the video. Let's try to solve the knapsack problem systematically. We might, for instance, plot all the fruits in two dimensions, weight and value. The melon is the most valuable single fruit, but also by far the heaviest. The strawberry, on the other hand, is the least valuable but also the lightest. All other fruits are somewhere between these extremes. It seems to be a good strategy to take the fruits which have a high value per weight ratio. The strawberry is the best in this regard. It has a value by weight ratio of 3 divided by 20, which is 0.15. We can compute this ratio for all the fruits and sort the fruits accordingly. Now we can just pick the most valuable fruit, one after the other, until our weight capacity is reached. This is known as the greedy approach. It greedily puts together a solution. In our example, we first take the strawberry, then the apple, then the banana, and the grapes. Together these four fruits already weigh 390 grams. Given a capacity of 500 grams, we can only fit 110 more grams. This is not enough for any of the three remaining fruits. Notice that we cannot cut the fruits, we can only select a whole fruit. Wasting 110 grams is a bad idea, since this solution only has a value of 40. We need to be more organized. We should be able to construct all valid subsets systematically, using recursion. We want to implement a function, knapsack, which has two parameters. The first parameter is a list of potential items, where each item has a weight and a value. The second parameter is the weight capacity. When calling this function, we first handle the base case right away. If the list is empty, then the length of the list is zero. If the length is zero, we cannot achieve any value, so our knapsack function can immediately return a value of zero. If the list is not empty, we use recursion. First, we split the list into two parts. The first item is assigned to the variable with the name first, and the rest of the list is assigned to the variable rest. Now we first compute the solution if we do take the first item. We only do this if the weight of the first item is at most the remaining capacity. Else the item is too heavy, and we do not need to consider it anymore. If the first item still fits, we call knapsack recursively. The items are simply the remaining rest of items. The remaining capacity is the original capacity minus the weight of our first item. The only alternative is to not take the first item. We again call knapsack recursively. This time we do not need to remove anything from the original capacity, since we didn't take the first item. In both cases we call knapsack with the same list, starting with the banana, which was the second item in our original list of items. If we take the apple, our remaining capacity drops to 500-80, which is 420. Both recursive calls then themselves call the knapsack function again. This is part of the recursion. Eventually both calls would return. In case we took the apple, a total value of 34 was achieved. If we didn't take the apple, a value of 42 was achieved. It looks like not taking the apple is more valuable. However, in the take variable we also add the value of the apple, which is 10. In this case take becomes 34 plus 10, which is 44. We return the maximum of both branches to the caller, in this case 44. So the best possible subset of fruits has a total value of 44. Backtracking is essentially just a smarter recursion. We again try to systematically construct all possible subsets, however, we are smarter in two ways. When looking at the recursion tree, we first include the items with the highest value density in our partial solution. We first try to use the strawberry, then the apple, the banana, etc. The execution of the recursion starts on top, at the root. Then we directly go down the leftmost path of the search tree. In other words, we first construct the greedy solution. This method of first constructing the most promising solution is called look ahead. Look ahead is the first trick of backtracking. These promising solutions will usually give us a high value early. We always compare against the highest known value. If we understand that we cannot achieve the best value so far anymore, we can cut the recursion early. This is known as pruning, and is the second trick of backtracking. The look ahead can be achieved naturally by simply sorting the list of items according to their value to weight ratio. We want to sort the items with a descending ratio, so we take the negative of the ratio. Then we simply call the recursive BT function, where BT stands for backtracking. Let us now look at the recursive function in more detail. At first, the BT function looks quite overwhelming. However, most of it is exactly the same as the recursive function before. If we gray out all the known parts, only a few lines of code remain. The most obvious change is the new parameter in the recursive function. We call this parameter missing. It is the value which is still missing in the current solution. We need to add at least missing value in order to catch up to the best solution found so far. Let's look at the upper part first. Because we sorted the items, the first item in items has the highest value to weight ratio. Let's assume that this is the apple. In the best case, all the remaining items have the same ratio as the apple. If we take the apple's ratio and multiply it with the remaining capacity, we have an upper bound of what value we can at most achieve with the items we were given. If this upper bound is less than the missing term, we know that we can prune the recursion. In this case, we simply return a value of zero. In the lower part, we need to compute the right missing parameters. First, we look at the left path. In this case, we take the first item. Now missing reduces by the value of the banana. When we return from the left path, we know how much value we achieved on the left side. This is stored in the take variable. For the right path, we must at least achieve this value, and we also must at least achieve missing, so the new missing becomes the maximum of these two. Let us summarize the main insights of this video. We have first introduced the knapsack problem, which served as an example for the whole video. Then we showed how to systematically construct all possible solutions using recursion. Finally, we showed how to do recursion in a smart way, but constructing promising solutions first. Thanks to this, we can often prune the recursion early because we know that a certain subtree does not have to be evaluated anymore, since it cannot achieve a better solution than the current best candidate solution. Essentially, backtracking combines the greedy approach with the recursive approach. Thanks for watching this video.